It's Duncan here. Sports talk, Matt Sports. Let's talk some NFL free agency, some 49ers. I don't usually talk football, but I've been getting requests for it, so let's go at it. First and foremost, please subscribe to the channel, like, and comment below. So let's talk. Okay. First and foremost, the good rebuild, we're going to have to start with our quarterback. We went out, we got Jimmy Garoppolo. Okay, this is a franchise quarterback. He has the ability to make all the plays with his feet and his arms. He's been outstanding for us with very little supporting cast. So, now that we have our franchise quarterback, what I'd like to do first is build up the offensive line with maybe a, maybe a Sullivan, John Sullivan, Sean Laval. Would be alright from Washington, but with our quarterback in place, and what's scary is Garoppolo, hasn't even thrown to Garcon yet, so he still has Pierre Garcon that he can throw to. He's going to be bringing Goodwin back, he's going to have Taylor back, so let's talk about how we help a little bit more. Let's bring him some more weapons. So the first thing I want to do is I want to give him a real quarterback. Let me stop this. I want to give him a real receiver. One of the best in the league. I want to give Garoppolo, Garcon, and Jarvis Landry with Goodwin and Taylor. Suddenly that receiving core is amazing. Let's just be honest. Absolutely amazing receiving core. We got a big man with Garcon who's going to catch a lot. You got your speed with Landry. He's probably a top five receiver. Goodwin was outstanding here. He has the speed to take the top off of defenses. Trent Taylor, he's your glue in between. I mean, this is a solid receiving core. Okay. Suddenly, Garoppolo has multiple wide receiving weapons, and San Francisco could suddenly have one of the best receiving cores in football. Okay. Now, keep that in mind, kick returns, not a problem, he's a specialist, so, I believe he has the potential to be an amazing piece for us, him and Garoppolo together, just simply outstanding. Now, we also know that Garoppolo loves his tight ends. And despite the fact that Selleck is alright, despite the fact that Kettle looks decent, I think we need to go out and get one more big weapon for him. And this guy is by the name of Tyler Eifert. He is well known for his red zone defense, or red zone receptions, touchdowns, massive touchdowns in the red zone. Okay, this guy comes in, and you can guarantee that if you can get in the red zone, he's automatic. Garoppolo to Eifert would be like mimicking Brady to Gronk. Okay, this would give Garoppolo a solid receiving core with an outstanding tight end core. At that point, all we would have to do is, again, stack the line, get a, figure out what we're doing for running backs, and our offense would be top-notch. So, with that being said, with a top-notch offense, the next thing we want to do is start working on our defense. So, we all know that our defense is somewhat lacking quarterback pressure. On comes DeMarcus Lawrence. He's a guy the Cowboys cannot afford to keep. He's a guy that can come right in, give you double-digit sacks. He's a three-down lineman, which means you can continue shuffling your players around. He would come in, he would take so much pressure off of Solomon and Buckner. I mean, suddenly with his presence, our defensive line would be one of the top D-lines in the league. Buckner, Armstead, Williams, or not, but Mitchell, with Lawrence, and, you know, Doomerville and all that. Wow. Okay, that's a stacked line. We had vast improvements at stopping the run. And, you know, now it's time to go after the quarterback. DeMarcus Lawrence is a guy that had double-digit sacks this year. And he could really boost up that for us. But that's not the only part of the defense. We need a lot of help in the secondary. And I believe the answer comes with this man, Tremaine Johnson. And before everybody says he's really old, keep in mind he's still a shutdown corner. He's still one of the best in the league. The Rams will not pay for him. They will not afford him. Cannot afford him. So by taking him, we are literally taking a top-notch corner away from our biggest rival next year. So not only do we help ourselves get better, but we help our rival get worse. This is a win-win for us. We have the money to afford him. He's the shutdown corner that we want. He fits the bill perfectly. With his assistance and the other guys that I've mentioned, it'd be hard for any team to really hang with that next year's 49ers squad. Now imagine that. Garoppolo to Landry, Garcon to Goodwin to Taylor, Garoppolo hands to Breida, maybe Hyde, Williams. He's backed behind the line. You know, with Solomon at center, Staley, LeVeau, maybe go out and draft a top-notch lineman. You go out and you get one of the better receiving red zone tight ends in the league. Suddenly that offense is almost unstoppable. Now you bring in a coach that knows how to plan. That offense is deadly. Now you throw in a defense that can control the line of six scrimmage, that has a double-digit sack guy on the team, that can get after quarterbacks, that can pressure, that can make throws. And then he's got to throw into a secondary with Tremaine Johnson back there. I mean, that's the making of a Super Bowl-type team. That's how you rebuild the 49ers. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Like my channel, share the message, get out there, guys. It's going to be a good year. Duncan, out.